It's here. Christmas is really here. Overflowing joy fills the air. Children all cheer as the time is here. But wait, COVID is everywhere, and there's a lot of despair. Am I truly happy or am I sad? Because it's just another year inside. No, I choose to be happy because of friends and family who I hold dear is still here to care and share, to celebrate with me this year. So instead of being sad, I think I'll be merry because Jesus Christ is on my side.
Before any magical reindeer and red pine sleigh, a child was born in Bethlehem in a manger full of hay. He was greeted not by princes or by kings who ruled the day, but by simple men called shepherds who had heard the angels say, "See the Savior comfort all who in a manger lay." Sometime after this event, four men came from far away to offer precious gifts to him and to kneel down and pray. This is the reason for Christmas, not a man in a fine sleep. Now while giving gifts has meaning, it should always be the same. I remember that Christ was born to show us all the way, that you and I be part of him, a family, come what may. We're here to learn what love means, to care, to give, and to play. And while we gather in his heart, kneel down and pray. This doesn't mean that Santa Claus has no role in the play, but if we cherish Christmas, we should share him in this way. Christ came to earth to give himself, to be the light of day, and we must learn to give ourselves to others in this way. When Santa comes with all of his gifts piled in his sleigh, it's really just simple of that child in the hay. So when Santa's gifts are open and the children start to play, we should take a moment with them to kneel down and pray, and remind each child that not one gift is truly from a sleigh, but that all good comes from the God above, the love, the light, and the way. Merry Christmas.
My name is Atiya Jones, and I am representing the class of 3H with a poem entitled Trini Christmas. Trini Christmas, oh what a joyous time, when friends and family come together to bust a line. Schools are out, so you hear happy children shout, neighbor, neighbor, bring out the ham, sorrel, pasta, wild meat and yam. At least a week before this joyous occasion, mothers recruit their children to be a part of the cleaning battalion. Christmas carols and parents can be heard playing aloud, while curtains and furniture stores are packed with crowd. It's a time for all to be jolly, celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, born to his virgin mother Mary. Away in a manger in Bethlehem, his birth was witnessed by his father and the three wise men.
Here's to Christmas, a time of remembering, a time of loving, a time for giving, a time of believing, a time of gratitude, a time to slow down, a time to simplify, a time of magic, a time of peace. Merry Christmas.
Christmas carols in the distance, laughter everywhere. I can smell Christmas in the air. Candy canes and bonbons, angels top the tree. There's presents over yonder, for one for you and me. Tinsel wrapping round and round, candles light the night, making Santa's journey sparkly and bright. A very Merry Christmas to your family, my friends. May your new year bring happiness, and may the joyful times not end. Merry Christmas to you all.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Rishmi Tangnat, and I am from the class of 3H. Christmas. Christmas is more than a day in December. It's all of those that we love to remember. It's carolers singing familiar refrains, bright colored stockings, and shiny toy trains. Streamers of tinsel and glass, Satan balls, latter, flat rings through the house and its walls. Christmas is more than a day in December. It's the magic and the love that we'll always remember.
Hi, My name is Phoebe Samarukas of 1S, and I'll be singing a song called O Come Holy Faithful. O come Holy Faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come, O come to Bethlehem. Come and behold Him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore Him. O come, let us adore Him. O come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord. Sing, choirs of angels, sing in exaltations, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest. O come, let us adore Him. O come, let us adore Him. O come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Samaya Flanders. I am in Form 1, the class of 1S. And today I will be singing Santa Claus is Coming to Town. Enjoy!
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees when you're asleep. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been good or bad. So be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and he's checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been good or bad. To be good, for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. The Santa Claus is coming to town.
Enjoy, and thank you very much for all listening, and have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Christmas, a season of blessings from heaven above. A season of pain for all those who love. A season of warmth and good cheer. A season of hoping for the coming new year.
Is burning bright, shining all on me, as I see the presents underneath the good old Christmas tree. And we don't night till Santa comes to wake me from my dreams. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. I see the children play outside like angels in the snow, Mom and Daddy share a kiss under the mistletoe. And we cherish all these simple things wherever we may be. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got these candles glowing in the dark.
Fives presents The Christmas Present, written by Brandon Mirage and narrated by Darcy Sukai and Devin Rodber.
The sun was brighter than ever on this special day, peeking through the curtains as it carefully drew life into the grand Robinson house. Millie had just rolled out of bed in her festive elf pajamas with a huge gaping yawn. The smell of her dad's freshly brewed coffee crept into her room, and her mother's famous French toast in the air brought a huge grin to her face.
Racing out of her room, she made a beeline for the kitchen, where she knew her family would be having breakfast. She attacked her little brother, Johnny, and her parents with hugs and kisses as soon as she saw them. "Merry Christmas," she squealed, utterly excited to open a present under the extravagantly decorated Christmas tree.
"Your breakfast is on the table, honey," her mom said while taking a bite of toast. "Can we just skip to the gift opening? Please, please." She gave her mother the puppy dog eyes, batting her eyelashes pleadingly. Mrs. Robinson sighed, but she had a smile on her lips. "Fine," she said. She could never say no to Millie.
Johnny and Millie raced to the living room where the Christmas tree stood tall and proud. It was decorated with an array of lights and ornaments. Perched atop it was a magnificent and shiny golden star. Mr. and Mrs. Robinson followed closely behind. Millie was so eager. She was practically bouncing in her seat. She had hoped her parents listened to her constant nagging for their new iPhone this Christmas.
Her mom handed her a small, delicately wrapped box. Grinning ear to ear, this made Millie's hopes rocket sky high. She viciously teared into her presents like a wild animal, only for the smile to fall completely off her face. Mrs. Robinson's smile slowly faded when she saw her daughter's expression. She had worked a lot of extra hours just to get her daughter the gift that she wanted.
Millie eyed her gift with distaste. "What's this?" she asked. "It's an iPhone 11, honey. What's wrong?" her mother asked, feeling a bit confused and hurt. "I asked for the iPhone 12. Were you deaf or something?" Millie's sudden outburst caught everyone's attention. "Millie, that's no way to speak to your mother," Mr. Robinson said. "What's wrong with the phone she got you?"
"Dad, I specifically asked for a pink iPhone 12, and look at this garbage." She practically shoved the phone in his face. "She got me a gray iPhone 11. So?" Johnny asked, annoyed at how spoilt and ungrateful his big sister was acting. "What's everyone at school going to think when I show up with this?" she exclaimed as she held the phone up.
"Millie," her father scowled at her, while her mother looked incredibly hurt about the whole ordeal. "I never get anything I want. This is the worst Christmas ever," she blared, storming out of the room. Millie huffled as she planted herself outside the front door, looking out at a somewhat empty street. As Millie sat there, the sound of loud laughter filled the emptiness. She looked across the fence to us and to her surprise, she saw the little girls from the house next door playing with what looked like a huge cardboard box.
"What in the world?" she muttered to herself. She then got up and walked closer to see what was really going on. Millie looked on in astonishment when she realized that these girls were playing with a makeshift dollhouse. It was made from a large cardboard box with chalk-drawn windows and doors. She stood there in disbelief as their laughter grew even louder.
"Excuse me," she called out to the little girls. "Why are you all so happy to be playing with just a box?" she asked. "Isn't it amazing?" one of the little girls squealed back at her. "Our mom and dad made it just for us." Millie stared at them in complete confusion. Wouldn't you prefer a real dollhouse from the toy store? What are your friends going to think?"
The little girls stopped for a minute and really focused on Millie. "This is so much better than a store-bought dollhouse. Our parents took their time and made it special for us. And we think our friends would be jealous to know that," they giggled as they continued playing. Millie suddenly remembered her dad dropping off groceries next door and telling her mom that the people there had lost their jobs due to the pandemic.
Tears filled Millie's eyes as she looked onto the genuine joy that stood before her. The feeling of guilt and shame flooded her entire body. Here she was, with everything she could want and more, yet ungrateful and resentful. She ran back inside the house and flung herself onto her mom's laps. "I'm so sorry, Mom," she cried. "I don't know what came over me. Please forgive me. I appreciate all that you and Dad have done for me. I can't imagine how hard it must have been for you both."
Mrs. Robinson responded, "Millie, honey, I know it wasn't the phone you wanted, but we must always remember to be thankful for what we have. Things can be taken away from us at any moment, so we must make the most of every day with the people we love. I'm sorry again, Mom. I'll never be ungrateful again. Thank you for the real Christmas present," Millie said. "This phone?" her dad asked. "No," she responded. "The reminder of what Christmas is all about."
This Christmas, let us all make every effort to remember the real reason for the season.
It is not about the presents or the material things.
It's about being grateful and thankful for all that we have been blessed with, our family, our friends, our safety, and our life.
Merry Christmas to everyone from the class of 5S.
Something lovely wrapped beneath a tree.